Good morning, brothers and sisters, and welcome to another beautiful day. It is Rhapsody time, reality time. Today is Friday, August the 21st, and our man of God would like to share a message entitled, The Little Cloud Means Something. Hallelujah. Our opening scripture is from the book of 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 44, and I read, And it came to pass at the seventh time that he said, Behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. And he said, Go up, say unto Ahab, Prepare thy chariot, and get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. Hallelujah! Oftentimes, many are too worried and overwhelmed by their problems and the circumstances of their lives to notice the blessings of God around them. The answer or miracle they need may already be in the little signs or details around them which they are not discerning enough to observe. But notice something different about the prophet Elijah in our opening verse. After 3.5 years of drought, he began praying to God for the heavens to open and bring forth rain. As he prayed, he sent out his servant several times to check if the rains were coming. Each time, the young man returned with a negative report saying, No, master, there's no sign of rain outside. At the seventh time, however, he came back saying, I'm not sure if it counts for anything, but I see a little cloud in the sky, the size of a man's hand. At this point, Elijah sprang to his feet and said, Yes, that's it. And immediately sent a message to King Ahab. Quick, get into your carriage and head for the city before the rain stops you. Hallelujah. Elijah's servant only reported that he saw a little cloud, but that was all Elijah needed. He knew he had made progress. He was able to observe something different in the present state of affairs. Can you observe something different in your life today? Like Elijah, choose to see the sign of change as an indication that you already have the victory. Hallelujah! Do not wait. Immediately affirm and keep affirming that you are victorious in Christ. Keep declaring your victory, confident that God's word and His life in you has made you whole and brought perfection to your physical body, your life, and circumstances. Recognize the work of God in you and around you and give Him glory. Refuse to allow your mind to be clogged with worries so you can hear God's voice and discern His presence, beauty, and signs. Like Elijah, see that you've made and are making progress and impact through the subtle signs in your everyday life. Glory be to God. Now, wherever you are, my brothers and sisters, kindly raise your hand and take this prayer right after me. Dear Father, my spiritual eyes are open to recognize your wondrous works, see your glory, revel in your beauty, discern your presence, and the visible and invisible signs you display, even in the minutest details for my attention. With this consciousness, I walk in victory and triumph in every situation and circumstances. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. My brothers and sisters, I highly recommend that you take some time today to study these following scriptures in order for you to further understand today's message. From the book of Zechariah, chapter 4, verse 10, and from the book of John, chapter 6, verse 9 to 11. Hallelujah! You know what to do next. Share this to your world. Tune in again tomorrow for another exclusive message from our man of God, Pastor Chris Oyakhilome. You are blessed.
We trust you have been blessed by this devotional. We invite you to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life by praying thus. O Lord God, I believe with all my heart in Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. I believe He died for me, and God raised Him from the dead. I believe He is alive today. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life from this day. Through Him and in His name, I have eternal life. I'm born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I'm now a child of God. Hallelujah! Congratulations! You are now a child of God. To receive more information on how you can grow as a Christian, please get in touch with us by emailing us at tni.msia@gmail.com. That's tni.msia@gmail.com. We look forward to hearing your testimony. You are blessed.